Hello my dear students, welcome back with a new video. Today's topic is about the measurement of atmospheric pressure. Means there are some device by which we can measure the value of atmospheric pressure. The device which can measure the atmospheric pressure, that is called the barometer. So there are three types of barometer. First one is the simple barometer, second is the Fortin's barometer, and third one is the aneroid barometer. So let's start about the simple barometer, or it is also called the Torricelli barometer, because at first Torricelli was a famous scientist and he invented this type of barometer. That's why this is called the simple barometer or the Torricelli barometer. Okay, so simple barometer uses a glass tube of 1 meter or 100 centimeter long, which is closed at one end is closed, another end is open, and one trough is needed, which is filled by the mercury. Okay, first the tube is, means that 100 centimeter tube is completely filled with mercury, by which no air is present inside the tube. Okay, now the open end is closed by the thumb, and it is then made upside down for several times, by which all the air present inside the tube comes out from the tube. Okay, I told simple barometer uses one tube of 100 centimeter length, which is filled by the mercury completely. After that, the open end is closed by the thumb, and it is then made upside down, by which all the air comes out from the tube. And after that, that completely filled tube, it is closed by the thumb, and it is inverted into the trough of mercury. It is inverted into the trough of mercury such that the open end is well immersed inside the trough, which is filled by the mercury. Okay, after that the thumb is removed carefully and make sure that no air should present inside the glass tube. That is all about the construction of the simple barometer. Now, what is the observation? Now, look, it has been observed the height of the barometric level, how the height of the mercury level, means height from the free surface of the mercury to the height, that is h equals to 76 centimeter. This is the observation, or we can say 0.76 meter. But initially it was 100 centimeter, but when it is being immersed, then the mercury level falls down and it is set up to a 76 centimeter height. That is called the barometric height. Now, what is the explanation of this one? Why the mercury level is set up at a height h which is equals to 76 centimeter? Look, to explain this one, I have taken one point is A, where this mercury level, means that amount of mercury is giving the pressure on the free surface, and this point is C, and here I have taken one point which is B, means at the free surface took another points I took. Now we know the atmosphere always gives the pressure on the free surface. See, this is the atmospheric pressure, means at a free surface at the same level, the atmosphere always gives the same pressure. Okay, now see, C and A and B, they are lying at a same surface, at the same plane also, at the same see, if this is a straight line, they all are lying at the same line, means at the same free surface they are lying. So whatever be the pressure at C and B, the same pressure will be there at the point A, but at this point the pressure which is due to the column of this mercury level. Okay, means whatever be the pressure at C, the same pressure will exit by the mercury at point A. Clear? Now look, so this mercury level is set up at a height 76 centimeters. So by applying, see, that value we know, because this is the atmospheric pressure, which is 1.03 into 10 to the power 5. Now see, at A, the pressure exerted due to the mercury column will come also this one. This is Pascal or Newton per meter square. We know the value of pressure P equals to H rho G. Now H equals to height of the mercury column means 0.76 into rho density of mercury, which is equals to 13.6 into 10 to the power 3 into 10. Now do the calculation, it will come near about 1.03 into 10 to the power 5 also. Some after the decimals, some numericals, some digits will be there also. So up to 3 decimal you take 1.03 into 10 to the power 5 pascal. Okay, that's why the mercury level is set up at a height 76 centimeter. This is the explanation of the simple barometer or the Torricelli barometer. You can ask the question, the barometric height will change according with the pressure or it will remain same. Means at some places, suppose the atmospheric pressure is increasing. So at some places, consider the atmospheric pressure is 2 into 10 to the power 5 newton per meter square or pascal. Then what will be the value of H? It will remain 76 centimeter or it will change? No, obviously it will change. That time when the atmospheric pressure is changing, here suppose 2 into 10 to the power 5, then at point A also 2 into 10 to the power 5, then obviously the value will change according to this value. So that time also H will change. Okay? So when the atmospheric pressure is changing, then the value of H also it will change. We can say the vertical height of the mercury column from the free surface of the mercury in the trough, it is the measure of the atmospheric pressure. What are the factors on which the barometric height depends? Means the factors affecting the barometric height. See, the barometric height means the height of 76 centimeter that will change when the atmospheric pressure changes. So at a particular places, that height from the tube means from here up to the free surface of the mercury, that will remain same. If the shape of the tube it changes, that time also it will remain same, means that height will remain same. And even if the tube is tilted from the original position, but that time also the vertical height from the free surface of the mercury up to the tube, up to the mercury column, up to this column, means that will remain also same at a particular place. So in another place, when the atmospheric pressure is changing, that time the height will change according with the pressure. You have to learn about the faulty barometer. What is faulty barometer? Look, in case of mercury we have seen, in case of tube, when it is immersed inside, the tube is immersed inside the trough of the mercury, then that height is H equals to 76 centimeter. But above that mercury level, there is a free space. This free space actually perfectly vacuum. That vacuum is called the Torricellian vacuum. Okay, but actually some mercury vapor is present there, but the pressure by the mercury vapor which is actually negligible, that's why we can consider there is a perfect vacuum, and that vacuum is called the Torricellian vacuum. Okay. Now, if somehow the air enters inside this vacuum, then what will happen? Then that air will give some pressure on the surface of the mercury. After that level, means level of that mercury, will decrease. So that time this barometer is called, that means that time it will not give the proper reading of the atmospheric pressure. So that time this barometer is called the faulty barometer. Okay. So when the air enters inside that vacuum, when the air will present inside that vacuum, this will also give some pressure. Because of this, the mercury level will goes down. Clear? And we can say about the faulty barometer, if somehow the water enters, then it immediately changes into the water vapor. That time also that water vapor will give some pressure on the mercury level. So that time also it will not show the proper reading, because the height of the mercury, it will decrease. So that's why it will not give the proper reading. That time this barometer is called the faulty barometer. What is the advantage of using mercury? Look, in case of mercury, we know the density of the mercury is maximum than the other liquids, and density of the mercury is 13.6 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube. If we use another liquid instead of mercury, then a large tube is needed, which is very difficult to use. That's why the mercury is used. And the mercury vapor present in the vacuum, that pressure by that mercury vapor, it is also negligible. That's why there will be no change in the barometric height. There is some another advantage of using mercury as a barometric liquid. See, next one important point I am giving, the mercury does not stick to the walls of the glass tube by which it can give the accurate reading, and it is obtained as a pure form. And another advantage of it, it is shiny and opaque by which we can take the proper reading, and it is easily seen while taking the observation. Okay, these are all the advantages of using mercury as a barometric liquid. What will happen if the water is used as a barometric liquid? Look, in case of water, the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. So if we use water instead of mercury, then 10.4 meter, this is very very long, that 10.4 meter tube is needed. Now if we use the mercury, means whose density is 30.6 into 10 to the power 3 kg per meter cube, that time only 1 meter tube is needed. This is the advantage, or this is the advantage of using mercury, and this is the disadvantage of using water. And second point I can give here, the water sticks to the walls by which it can give the inaccurate reading, and it is not shiny, it is transparent. Okay, this is the one of the most important point. And one more important point is, when the water is used, then the water vapor will present inside the vacuum, then it will give the pressure, that pressure exerted by the water vapor, it is much more than the mercury vapor. That's why it will give the inaccurate reading. So these are the disadvantages of using water, okay, as a barometric liquid. What are the demerits of the simple barometer? See, in case of simple barometer, there is no protection of the glass tube, and also in case of trough, it is a free surface, means there is also no protection. That's why there is a chance that the impurities may fall inside the trough of the mercury, and by which it get mixed with the mercury. So this is one of the most demerits. Second demerit is, it is not portable, means it is very difficult to move from one place to another place. It can give the value of atmospheric pressure at a particular places. Now the third demerit is, see, here no scale is attached with the glass tube, so it is very difficult to take the height of the mercury. Suppose at a place the mercury level or the atmospheric pressure changes, then what will happen? If the atmospheric pressure changes, means if the atmospheric pressure increases, then the barometric height also it will increase. And when the means certain amount of some amount of mercury will flow inside the glass tube, but and when the atmospheric pressure decreases also, that time the height of the barometer, height of the mercury, it will decrease. But see, as there is no scale attached with the glass tube, so it is very difficult to measure the barometric height or the height of the mercury. So these are the all demerits of the simple barometer. To remove this, after that the 14th barometer comes, there all the difficulties has been removed. That's why you have to learn about the 14th barometer, because there is some demerits, there is some disadvantage of using the simple barometer. Okay, so today's class up to this. In next video I will discuss about the 14th barometer, by which all the difficulties, all the demerits of the simple barometer has been removed. Okay, thank you.